My name is Mathia Karreman, and I worked as a postdoc in the lab of Yannick Schwab here at the EMBL in Heidelberg. And my project was to facilitate a 3D correlative microscopy, meaning actually that you could easily go from 3D in vivo imaging of live specimen to 3D electron microscopy. The reason why I started working with Amira is because I desperately needed to find a way to take one data set and to be able to move that in 3D space into the second data set. So I had a data set that was coming from in vivo imaging and I needed somehow to be able to manipulate it and move it into a data set that was coming from an X-ray machine. And the only software that was able to do that was actually Amira. So the challenge that we had at the beginning of this project is that we wanted to look at how tumor cells were crossing the blood-brain barrier. So to basically see during the process of metastasis or the spreading of cancer, how tumor cells were getting out of blood vessels in the brain. And we worked together with the group of Professor Frank Winkler downtown at the DKFZ, the German Cancer Research Center. And they have this beautiful model system where they build small windows in the skull of mice. And they can do in vivo imaging. So the mouse is asleep and we can look at tumor cells that are arrested in the brain of the mice. However, we were very interested in looking at these cells at higher resolution using 3D electron microscopy. But then you find, using in vivo imaging, you find one cell in a mouse brain. And then to be able to find that specific cell back using an electron microscope, it's a very, very difficult and time-consuming process. So you need to somehow narrow down the place or the volume that you're looking at and to really find back the proper position inside your sample. So what we did, the process that we were working with, is that in vivo imaging was done downtown at the DKFZ, and then I received a perfusion fixed mouse brain. It's about this big. And I took out a biopsy at the position where the imaging was done. So I knew that I would have a chunk of tissue, it's about this big, that had one cell that we were interested in. But of course, this one cell, it's extremely small, and the chunk of biopsy is still relatively big. So I did the processing for electron microscopy, and then I have a very dark plastic embedded piece of tissue inside the resin block. So what we needed to do is find a way to find back this single tumor cell in the brain biopsy. So what we did in the end is that we actually took an X-ray scan of the sample. And in this X-ray scan, we could see the vasculature inside the mouse brain. So we could not see the tumor cell itself, but we could see the blood vessels. And luckily enough, during the in vivo imaging, we can also see the blood vessels because they are stained with a fluorescent dye. So what we did using Amira is that we made a 3D model of the in vivo imaging. So we did a surface rendering, which shows the position of the tumor cell and also the blood vessels. And then from the X-ray dataset, we also made a 3D model that shows the blood vessels. And then we basically identified common points. So let's say that this is the in vivo dataset showing the tumor cell with respect to the blood vessels. And this is the 3D model of the X-ray dataset, which shows the blood vessels. And using the landmark module, we identified similar points in both datasets. And then Amira is able to overlay this in vivo dataset right on top of the X-ray dataset. And now we know that here, that's the position where my tumor cell is inside the resin block. So now I know exactly in X, Y, and Z where my tumor cell is. And this allows me to go to the microtome and very specifically remove all the brain material that I'm not interested in so that I can expose the tumor cell for 3D electron microscopy. I recommend Amira because it's very powerful software. You can do a lot with your images. There's certain unique tools that are not offered by different types of imaging processing tools. It's actually very good both for electron microscopy and for fluorescence microscopy, which is quite extraordinary because there's typically a software is focusing on either one of those. And I guess as soon as you start working with it, you become a little bit of an addict. So it's really something that you can do so much with the software that it's, I mean, you can very quickly browse through your data. You can make very beautiful 3D segmentations and visualizations of your data. You can make very nice movies. So this is, yeah, I would really recommend Amira.